B. Johnson, the 36th president.
Born August 27, 1908, near Johnson City, Texas, in a town named after his family, whom had settled there many generations before, Lyndon Baines Johnson grew up under difficult circumstances due to his family's financial problems, but ultimately overcame those obstacles through hard work and ambition to become the 36th president of the United States of America. As a young adult, Johnson attended Southwest Texas State Teachers College, where he pursued a degree in education, after which he spent 4 years teaching in a small Hispanic school in an impoverished area of Texas along the U.S.-Mexico border. Johnson then pursued a degree from Georgetown University in law while serving as a congressional aide in our U.S. Congress. In 1934, Johnson met Claudia Alta Taylor, known to her friends and family as Lady Bird Johnson, whom he later married that year in November. The two went on to have two daughters, Linda and Lucy. By 1937, Johnson had won a special election to fill the seat of a recently deceased Texas House member. Johnson retained his congressional seat for a total of 5 more terms. After an unsuccessful run for the Senate seat in 1941, Johnson became the first member of Congress to volunteer for active military duty in the U.S. Naval Reserves during World War II. In 1942, while boarding a B-26 fighter plane named the Wabash Cannonball, Johnson made a last-minute exit off the plane to use the bathroom. Upon his return, LBJ was told he would have to board a different plane because the one he had been on had already departed. Later that day, Japanese forces shot down the Wabash Cannonball over New Guinea with no survivors found. In 1948, LBJ won a seat in the U.S. Senate after narrowly defeating the Democratic primary by a mere 87 votes. Upon his victory, allegations of voter fraud began to swarm, and Johnson was given the sarcastic nickname Landslide Lyndon. Despite the nickname and repeated calls for investigation, LBJ went on to serve 12 years in the Senate and obtained the coveted role of Senate Majority Leader in 1955. By 1960, Johnson's political ambitions were focused on winning the office of the president, but a young and popular Democratic politician from Massachusetts, better known as John F. Kennedy, defeated Johnson in the Democratic primary that year. However, all hope was not lost for LBJ, as Kennedy would extend an invitation to Johnson to become his vice presidential running mate. On November 22, 1963, the U.S. entered into a state of shock upon learning of the assassination of President Kennedy while riding in a motorcade in Dallas, Texas. That evening, aboard Air Force One, Johnson took the presidential oath of office and promised the grieving nation that he would continue Kennedy's progressive vision for America. In the 1964 presidential election, Johnson was able to easily defeat Republican candidate Barry Goldwater. During his term, LBJ instituted a collection of social reforms in an effort to build a better society, or a great society, for all Americans. Some major measures included in Johnson's Great Society program included the creation of Medicare and Medicaid to provide the elderly with health care, improvements in public education, crime prevention measures, and environmental policies to improve air and water quality. And Johnson didn't stop there. He went on to sign into law 2 of the most notable pieces of legislation of the Civil Rights era. The Civil Rights Act of 1964, which outlawed discrimination based on race, color, religion, sex, or national origin, as well as prohibited the unequal application of voter registration requirements and racial segregation in schools, employment, and public accommodations. And the Voting Rights Act of 1965, which prohibited racial discrimination in voting. Also of note was Johnson's appointment of Thurgood Marshall, the first African-American justice to serve on the Supreme Court. Despite many of the successful domestic policies instituted by LBJ via his Great Society program, there was one foreign policy issue that haunted Johnson's presidency: Vietnam. In an effort to contain the spread of communism around the world, LBJ escalated the U.S. involvement in the Vietnam War. Over time, Johnson lost support for his war efforts As the U.S. continued to not make any headway in winning the battle and the casualties continued to pile up. It was at this point in time when LBJ announced he did not intend to make a bid for the White House in the 1968 presidential election. After leaving the White House, Johnson and his wife Lady Bird returned to his ranch in Texas and lived there until his death in 1973. I'll leave you with this famous quote from LBJ that I think is very relevant to the times we live now. "Yesterday is not ours to recover, but tomorrow is ours to win or lose."